Hi everyone, it's Tania, and today I have a video that a lot of you have been requesting. How can you come to study in Finland? I have divided this video in 6 parts. That is applying, getting the visa, financing your studies, scholarships, accommodation and travel. As many of you know, Finnish education has been highly recognized worldwide during the last few years. And you might also have heard that Finnish education is free. Well, that is a lie. Finnish education is not really 100% free because it comes out from all the taxes that Finnish people pay out of their salary, like every year. And well, anyone working in Finland will actually have to pay those taxes. That's not your question, right? You want to know how to study in Finland. So I'm gonna tell you how to do it. It all starts with an application, and the place that can help you the most is a website called studyinfinland.fi. I'm gonna put it down below in the description, so do not worry about that. This is a website that I used before coming to study in Finland, and it's really easy to follow, and it's very clear, and it specifies everything that you need to do before coming here. After you have submitted your application, you're gonna be required to make an entrance examination. This will define whether or not you are accepted into the university. This entrance examination can be either taken in a Finnish embassy in your own country or strictly in the university area. So it depends. You have to find out, like you have to ask either by email or phone where is the entrance examination going to be and if you can apply for an entrance examination to be in your embassy, like a Finnish embassy in your community. After you have been admitted to a Finnish university, the next step is to tramit your visa. To apply for a visa, you will also have to contact your embassy, like Finnish embassy in your country, and you will have to present an official letter that you have been accepted into a Finnish university. Also, make sure to start tramiting your visa with at least 4 months in advance, because sometimes tramit for making the visa can take really long. So if you already got accepted to a Finnish university, make sure that you tramit your visa right away. There might be different requirements depending on the country, but two of the most important, I guess, is your bank statement and the health insurance. Why is the Finnish embassy going to ask for your bank account and like all this information? So this is the point where we are starting to talk about financing your studies in Finland. If you're gonna apply for a student visa, you have to prove that you are financially stable to live through your studies. The other option is that you have to have a proof of income, and this has to be from 500 euros to 900 euros every month. Planning your financial situation is a really important part before coming to Finland, because it's really hard for foreigners to find any job. So if you're trying to come here with the hopes that you're gonna find a job and then like work through your studies, it might be quite risky, to be honest. Most of the foreigners do not get jobs that easily. First of all, because of the lack of Finnish language skills. And also, if you're a student, you're not allowed to work as many hours as a normal worker. So I would really recommend you that you plan your financial situation really, really good before coming to Finland. What about scholarships? Does Finland grant any scholarships of any kind? The answer is yes. Finnish government do grant scholarships, but most of these scholarships are going to research, like people that has already like a PhD or like the doctoral title, and that they are doing research in Finland. Unfortunately, Finnish government do not grant any scholarships for going through a degree or a master's, only for a doctoral and research. And this is mainly because the education is already free for foreigners. So I don't think that you can really get any scholarship from Finnish government. But what you can do is to try to find any other scholarships that are granted on your own country, or through internet. There's a lot of people, or there's a lot of organizations granting scholarships through internet, so that could be one option. Alright, so once you already have a place in the university, you have apply for a visa, and then you have planned your financial situation, it's also time for you to start planning your accommodation and like where are you going to go, where are you going to live, and all these kind of things. I already have a video about accommodation in Finland, and like you can find it right here, I guess, or right there, I don't know. So go and check out the video about accommodation in Finland. There are two types of student accommodation in Finland. One of them is the accommodation that is provided by student organization, and that will be like really cheap or like cheaper than a normal one. The second one is the private accommodation that you will like contact a landlord or like a person or a company. So this has to be part of your financial plan, since accommodation can be quite expensive in some places, like in Helsinki or big cities. So it really is different, and you have to be prepared for whatever you're gonna get, and well, just make sure it's on your plan. And finally, planning your travel. After you have everything in order, like all your papers and the visa is in order, you can finally start planning your travel. And really, like if you're coming from outside Europe, the tickets can be quite expensive. So I really recommend you that you buy your ticket like at least with 2 months in advance, just so it gets a little bit cheaper. But if you get your visa like super fast and like all your tramites are going really well, then you can maybe buy your ticket like maybe 3 to 4 months in advance. Another thing that I would like to tell is that when you're coming for the first time to study in Finland, you are not going to have a student card. Like your student card is gonna come like after a month that you are being in Finland. So when you arrive to Helsinki, and if you need to go like for example from Helsinki to Rovaniemi, like Lapland or something really far, you're gonna have to travel with all your luggage and like all the things, plus it's going to be really expensive if you don't have a student card. Remember that the student discounts for traveling in Finland only comes once you are a student officially in Finland, and then you have like a card. In the best of the cases, your university will give you a letter that will state that you are a student in that university, and you might be able to get a student discount for the train or the bus. But if you have the chance to book your flights straight to the city where you're going, that might be even cheaper and easier for you while traveling and getting here. I have also done a video about like cheap traveling in Finland. Go and check it out. It's gonna be here, just here. So that was it for today, guys. Thank you very much for watching. So if you have any other questions, just write them down in the comments down below, and I'll be really happy to answer. If you like this video, please give thumbs up and subscribe to my channel so I can keep doing more awesome videos about Finland. Thanks for watching, and bye bye.